Hello viewers, this is Rajiv Bhoumik and you are watching my channel Make Things Easy. In this video, I am going to tell you about probable interview questions for safety professionals. Initially, following questions will be asked: name, qualification, family background, current work experience if any. Then the main interview will start. Probable interview questions will be: what is EHS, what is HIRA and what is aspect impact analysis, what is life cycle approach, what is ETP and STP, what is machine guarding, interlock and both hand switches, what is PPEs, what is accident investigation, what is emergency preparedness and mock drill, what are the environmental tests, what is work permit system, what are the differences in unsafe condition, unsafe act, near miss and accident, what is MSDS, what are the legal requirements, what are the firefighting systems. Now, if selected, following things will be discussed: why want to join this company, company's requirement for this post, salary, etc. We'll start one by one. Number one is, what is EHS? E for environment, H for health, S for safety. Environment means creating a systematic approach to complying with environmental regulations. Health means it should have the working practices and systematic activities that prevent or reduce the risk of harm to people. Safety means it involves creating organized efforts and procedures for identifying workplace hazards and reducing accidents. Number two is HIRA, that is Hazard Identification Risk Assessment. I will explain this matter with this table. I'll start with main gate. Process is main gate. Sub-process is outside vehicle coming inside the premises. Hazard is unskilled or new driver. Consequence is accident may occur inside the premises. Existing control is checking of driving license. Now we have to give some score from 1 to 10. So for severity, I have given 3, occurrence 2, detection 1. Now RPN. RPN is risk priority number. It is the multiplication of severity, occurrence and detection. So if we multiply 3 into 2 into 1, it will come 6. Now organization has to fix some cutoff mark. So suppose cutoff mark is 30 and RPN is below 30, then no need to take further action. So here existing control is sufficient. But if RPN is more than cutoff mark, then organization needs to take some action, some task force, some project to reduce that hazard. Now I'll explain you aspect impact analysis. So this is the table. Process is main gate. Activity is outside vehicle coming inside the premises. Aspect is smoke from vehicle. Impact is air pollution. Existing control is pollution under control, PUC certificate checking. It's a legal requirement. Now here also you have to give some score. So severity 4, occurrence 6, detection 1. Here RPN is 24. Here also there will be a cutoff mark. If the RPN is more than cutoff mark, then organization has to take some EMP, that is environment management program, to reduce that hazard. Or if the RPN is below 30, then no need to take action. So if the RPN is more than cutoff mark, then it is a significant requirement, and if the RPN is below cutoff mark, then it is not a significant requirement. But as because it's a legal thing, so I have taken it as significant. Company's all processes and activities are to be analyzed by HIRA and aspect impact analysis. These two are the first and main activities for a safety professional. And HIRA is mainly for human safety and aspect impact analysis is mainly for environment. Number three is life cycle approach of a product. Life cycle approach means the whole chain of a product's life cycle from cradle to grave has a responsibility and a role to play by each stage, taking into account all the environmental impact and human safety. I will explain this matter with a table. In this table, there are 5 columns: process, activity, aspect, impact, and control. In the process column, we have to consider all the stages like understanding the requirement, design, deciding right materials, purchase of raw materials, storage, manufacturing, dispatch, product use by customer, disposal of leftover product, and packaging. After this, activity, aspect, impact, control columns are to be filled. Like this, all products are to be analyzed. Number 4 is ETP and STP. ETP means effluent treatment plant for treatment of industrial waste water. STP means sewage treatment plant for treatment of house waste liquids from toilets, baths, showers, kitchens, sinks, etc. Now, various steps of ETP and STP are pre-treatment, screening, grit removal, flow equalization, fat and grease removal, primary treatment, secondary treatment, and tertiary treatment. Now, treated water should meet all the parameters as prescribed by Pollution Control Board. For that, chemical dosing is done in ETP-STP to get desired parameters in the outlet effluent. Permissible standards in India, pH is 5.5 to 9, TSS, that is total suspended solid, is less than 100 mg per liter, oil and grease is less than 10 mg per liter, BOD, that is biochemical oxygen demand, is less than 30 mg per liter, and COD, that is chemical oxygen demand, is less than 250 mg per liter. After treatment, accumulated sludge to be disposed of to PCB approved agencies. All the necessary PCB rules to be followed for storing and transporting the sludge. Treated water can be used for gardening, toilet flush, or can be drained to outlet of the organization which is going to the common drain. Number 5 is machine guard, interlock, and both end switches. All moving parts of machine to be guarded. Interlocking system should be there for some machines. If the door is not locked, machine will not run. If both hands are used, then only machine will operate. These type of switches are to be used for specially press machines. All these things will reduce the possibilities of accidents. Number 6 is personal protective equipment, that is PPE. Various PPEs are hand gloves, safety shoes, helmet, earplug, goggles, apron, nose mask, safety harness, etc. Few important points about PPE. PPE should be the last option to protect human being. PPE to be procured from genuine approved vendors. PPE to be maintained properly and kept in a hygienic place. Proper training to be given on how to use PPEs. Proper disposal of PPE to be ensured after use. In which workplace, what PPE to be used to be communicated or displayed. Required PPEs must be available at workplace. Number 7 is accident investigation report. After accident, proper investigation to be done. In a typical investigation report, following points should be mentioned: name of the injured person, machine or area, date of accident, detailed explanation of accident, immediate treatment, follow-up treatment, investigation team, root cause of the accident, immediate action, permanent corrective action. Accident details to be displayed in similar areas with photographs so that people become alert next time for similar type of accident. Number 8 is emergency preparedness and mock drill. Emergency preparedness refers to the steps taken to be ready to respond to and survive during an emergency. Organization should have an emergency team and train them by competent authority. Few emergency preparedness could be on earthquake, flood, explosion in gas cylinder, ETP-STP failure, power outage, water outage, major cut and burn injury, electrical shock, explosion in gas and oil pipeline, windstorm, fire, chemical spillage, etc. Now let us see what is mock drill. Mock drill is a practice to know how to handle the real life situation if it comes, which may be of any type of emergency, danger, calamity that occurs all of a sudden without any prior warning or very little time to face the situation. Few mock drill examples are fire mock drills, chemical spillage mock drills. A typical report of mock drill could be like this: type of mock drill, date, start time, end time, total response time, head count, detailed description. Number 9 is environmental tests. Effluent water tests at ETP, STP inlet and outlet, stack analysis of DG set, air quality monitoring of various places inside the premises and periphery, noise tests of various places inside the premises and periphery at daytime and night time. As per Pollution Control Board norms, all these tests are to be done by Pollution Control Board approved testing agencies, and all reports are to be submitted to Pollution Control Board as per required frequency. Number 10 is work permit system. Now let us see what are the various work permits. Electrical work permit, hot work permit, cold work permit, work at height, work at confined space, radiation work permit, road cutting and blockage permit, excavation work permit, etc. Now, work permit to be obtained from safety department before committing these hazardous work. Some kind of signs are to be displayed while doing this work. Proper vigilance to be maintained when the work is in progress. All procedures are to be strictly followed mentioned in the permit. After completion of work, permit to be submitted to safety department. Number 11, unsafe condition, unsafe act, near miss and accident. Unsafe condition is an unsatisfactory physical condition existing in a workplace environment immediately before an accident. Unsafe act is any act that deviates from a recognized safe way or specified method of doing a job and which increases the probabilities for an accident. Near miss. A near miss is a near hit or a close call or a nearly a collision in an unplanned event that has the potential to cause but does not actually result in human injury. Accident is an unfortunate incident that happens unexpectedly and unintentionally, typically resulting in damage or injury. Number 12 is MSDS, that is Material Safety Data Sheet. MSDS is the document that lists information relating to occupational safety and health for the use of various substances and products. The globally harmonized system of classification and labeling of chemicals contains a standard specification for MSDS. The MSDS follows a 16-section format which is internationally agreed. Now let us see what are those 16 sections. Number 1, identification of product and company. Number 2, hazards identification. Number 3, composition and information on ingredients. Number 4, first aid measures. Number 5, firefighting measures. Number 6, accidental release measure. Number 7, handling and storage. Number 8, exposure control and personal protection. Number 9, physical and chemical properties. Number 10, stability and reactivity. Number 11, toxicological information. Number 12, ecological information. Number 13, disposal considerations. Number 14, transport information. Number 15, regulatory information. Number 16, other information. Number 13 is legal requirement. As per EHS, safety professional must maintain a legal register. Legal register can be like this format: serial number, description, related rule and act with year, done on, due on, responsibility, original document kept with whom. So this kind of legal register can be maintained. In legal requirements of EHS, there are few varieties like obtaining license, certificates or approvals and their renewal. Few examples like consent to operate, hazardous waste authorization, factory license, etc. Then submission of various reports to government authorities like environmental statement, hazardous waste disposal manifest, etc. Then submission of fees to government authorities like water cess, etc. Now, country to country, state to state, these legal requirements varies. Now, EHS department should devise some mechanism to get latest update about new legal requirements or any changes in the existing requirement. Number 14 is firefighting system. First, we'll discuss about fire extinguisher. There are 5 type of materials used in fire extinguisher. Number 1 is water, number 2 is foam, number 3 is dry chemical powder, number 4 is carbon dioxide, number 5 is wet chemical. Now there are 5 type of fire extinguishers. A type is for wood, paper, leaf and inside materials are H2O and CO2. B type is for oil, paint, grease and inside materials are DCP, foam, CO2. Here DCP is dry chemical powder. C type is for gas, that is hydrogen, helium, and inside materials are DCP and CO2. D type is for chemical, that is magnesium, sodium, etc. And inside material is DCP. And E type is for electrical, and inside materials are DCP and CO2. Now we'll discuss about fire hydrant. Fire hydrant pump systems are high pressure water pumps designed to increase the firefighting capacity of a building by boosting the pressure in the hydrant service when main is not enough. Now we'll discuss about fire sprinkler. A fire sprinkler system is an active fire protection method consisting of water supply system. I'll explain few more points for safety professional. PUC, that is Pollution Under Control Certificate, is compulsory for all vehicles coming inside the premises. It is always better to display main EHS related data in a display board inside the premises at least one or two places. Periodically toolbox talk to be arranged for employees on safety. You can watch one of my video in my channel on toolbox talk. For all liquid materials, secondary containment to be provided. Containment should hold the whole quantity if leakage happen. Yearly once health checkup to be arranged through competent agency for all employees. Necessary tests to be done according to work hazard. All gas cylinder are to be chained at standing position. Materials rack are to be guarded with protection stand. Emergency shower and eye wash arrangement to be made at forklift battery charging zone and chemical area. Spillage kit to keep in store and quality assurance lab. Training to be provided how to use spillage kit. Spillage mock drill also to be arranged. Light, siren, roof, mirror, seat belt, etc. to ensure in forklift. Forklift key not to keep in the vehicle when not in use. Only trained driver to operate the forklift. LOTO. LOTO means lockout tagout. It is needed for safety while doing maintenance. You can watch one of my video in my channel on LOTO. First aid boxes to keep in various locations in the premises. All medicines are within expiry date to ensure. Locking pin to ensure in all crane hooks. This will ensure no fall of goods. Company provided food and drinking water can be tested from competent agency once in a year. Lift, hoist, crane, pressure vessels, earth pit, ammeter, voltmeter, building stability, etc. to be tested. Concave mirrors to provide in various locations to prevent accident. So viewers, thanks for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video. If you have not subscribed my channel, please subscribe it and like this video, share this video. And if you want to comment some things, please leave your comment in the comment section. Thank you once again for watching this video.